Genesis 1 is the newest paid DLC for Ark Survival Evolved on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One. At face value, Ark Genesis 1 is a beautiful new map that throws in new concepts to an already standardized formula. Ark's appeal is its official network. Yes, many people play on private servers, but the largest and longest running community is on official PvP. So with that official network, Wildcard Studios has to develop DLCs that can transfer to their various maps. The new creatures are truly unique and bring a fresh take on an already familiar game. Seriously, I give Wildcard a lot of grief, but the creativity of these new creatures is really next level. Genesis is a multi-biome simulation where you're accompanied by a robot companion. Now, before I continue, I will say I've been playing this on official PvP since launch for a little over 2 weeks now on PlayStation 4 Pro. My girlfriend plays right next to me on a standard PlayStation 4, and they've been rolling out patches almost every day to fix various bugs on the map. So yes, the game is very buggy right now to an extent where it's pretty game-breaking, but they are trying to rectify that, so I'll give them credit. But just be warned, if you hop in right now, there are going to be some challenges as far as bugs in the game, but it's still playable, it's still a lot of fun. I think that it needs a huge boost from a performance standpoint, but anyway, we'll continue the review. Your robot companion has the ability to transport you between biomes and trade hexagrams, an easily earnable in-game currency for various needed items. To pivot, the hexagram trade is really a nice way to get started. With a few thousand hexagrams, you can purchase enough materials to get a pretty basic stone base and gear set going. I think it's easy to forget that early game is a struggle of being murdered, starving, or freezing to death as we sit in our turret-capped bases on our high mountains. So this hexagram trade is a really edgy system that I think is a fair trade-off sharing loot like in Extinction. For example, when you run certain drops in Extinction, everyone has to share, whereas in the hexagrams you get private loot and your hexagrams are permanently in your inventory. There are also some really interesting in-game missions completely new to Ark. I was really shocked when I first tried them. Keep in mind, this is a survival game, and the early game aspect really pushes your ability to survive. The biomes are extreme takes on biomes we are already familiar with. There are new environmental hazards to really test your patience. Each map has new textures and graphics to bring a fresh, beautiful take to the game, new creatures, and new flora, which is absolutely breathtaking. Speaking of biomes, the ocean biome allows players to really explore the underwater for the first time. Before, there were so many challenges of the water being accessible to all. In this map, the water biome gives you increased speed, decreased stamina drain, and decreased oxygen drain. The other biomes follow suit with some sort of special gimmick that makes them all unique. I think it's a great map for veteran or new players. With all that being said, unfortunately, a large portion of the community is still toxic. In the first few days of the DLC, we were DDoSed almost every day for hours at a time, and it really ruins the gameplay experience for anyone on that server. Other than that, you still have to worry about griefers, crafting grenades, and blowing up your stone base within a few hours of a new DLC being launched. The DLC itself seems pretty stable, minus several game crashes. I noticed that people on the standard PS4 crash or disconnect a lot more often than the Pro, and on a Pro I've experienced it a lot less. As I mentioned before, we've seen micro patches almost every day where they'll take the server offline to launch a new version. I think in the upcoming weeks that'll start to slow down as they kind of work through all the bugs that the community is feeding back. You know, it's $20 for the map, $35 for the season pass. I think it's a really unique experience. It's fun, and if you've never played Ark, you can hop right into this map, and it's going to be great. And if you've played Ark for years, it's still going to be a fun map to jump into. It's a gorgeous map. The new models are really beautiful. Outside of a performance perspective, I mean, this map is really awesome. Granted, the new creatures are super broken, but with every paid DLC, we always get broken creatures that really make the game interesting. Plus, they have to give the creatures some sort of new identity. I will warn you, on official, the flyers are disabled on this map. And flying on a tech suit. So flying is not really a thing, but with the Bloodstalker, which is the spider-like creature, you can swing pretty much like Spider-Man, climb walls, etc., etc. And then, of course, there's the tech skiff, which allows you to fly around the map as well. But anyway, I do recommend picking up this title if you like Ark, if you like survival games, dinosaur games, anything of that nature, online PvP, this is definitely a great DLC to pick up. As they iron out some of these bugs, then I think some of the community will start to appreciate the DLC more. And on that note, I will say that from a PvP standpoint, strictly speaking, I think that Ark Survival has the best PvP experience. I don't want to say experience, but it's definitely... There's no other game that has PvP like Ark, because you have to invest so much before you actually PvP. Anyway, I hope this review was helpful to you. If you have questions about the DLC, Genesis 1, please post them below. I look forward to continue playing this. It's been a lot of fun so far. I appreciate you guys watching. Like, subscribe, and until next time.